Just as you can create a reflection vector to perform reflection mapping, you can also create a refraction vector and use that instead to access the environment map. This can be combined with the color of the object to get different variations of a material that looks a fair bit like glass. Snell's law is what's normally used for computing the refraction direction. It's named after Willebrod Snellius, a Dutch astronomer and mathematician from the 17th century. However, it turns out that Ibn Sal, a Persian mathematician, discovered this back in 984 AD. This is an old formula and is as follows. In this diagram, we have a ray of light traveling through, say, the air and hitting a transparent object, say, made of glass. In this equation, N1 and N2 are the index of refraction of the air and glass, respectively. The index of refraction is a physical value for a material that is essentially how much slower light travels through it compared to light in a vacuum. As examples, here are some indices of refraction. Air is just about 1, it's very close to vacuum. Diamond is very different than glass, and so that's one thing that differentiates them. When the index of refraction of the second material is greater than the first, the effect is that the sine of the angle must be smaller to compensate. This means the angle from the normal becomes smaller. In other words, light bends towards the normal when going from air to glass. The effect is reversed in the other direction. Going from glass to air causes the light to bend at a greater angle. This is what refraction mapping does. It changes the direction of the light passing through the transparent object. However, real objects have at least two refraction events when light passes through them, both when entering and exiting the surface. Refraction mapping does just the one refraction. Refraction mapping is not quite as convincing as reflection mapping, in my opinion. Part of the reason is that the distortions produced are not as complex as the real thing. More importantly, all that you can ever see through these transparent objects is the environment map, nothing else. Notice with the spheres demo, lovely as it is, that you can't see any spheres through any other spheres. It's possible to make this happen, but it is a lot of extra computation.